I played the President of the United States in Olympus Has Fallen, President Benjamin Asher, and I get taken hostage in this movie by a group of North Korean terrorists, and luckily Mike Banning, a.k.a. Gerard Butler, comes and helps me out.
Congratulations on a fantastic film. I think the obvious question... I think you're handsomer. The obvious question, what excited you about the project, and how do you prepare for being the leader of the free world?
Well, Antoine Fuqua, the director, really excited me because he's my kind of director. He's a man's man. He's tough. He expects excellence from his actors. He's a great storyteller. He's a pro professional filmmaker. And he's just a generally all around a good guy. And I like working for good guys. And Jerry had a great script, you know, that he's produced. And I wanted to be a part of it. And, you know, every American kid wants to be, you know, the President of the United States. They believe that they can be. It's quite something. It's kind of like a... like an initiation in America. You know, every kid has to know that they can become president if they want to, and it's very something special about America. And so to play the president, I have a lot of respect for the office, and I tried to give it my all and be an honest, good president.
Talking about good guys, Jerry, of course, a big part of this film. Can you tell us a little bit about his character and how involved he was behind the scenes as well?
I mean, Jerry is this film, you know. I mean, he's he put it together, and he deserves all the credit. He put everything into this, long nights and blood, sweat, and tears, and he's very proud of this movie, which is good to see. He loves to talk about it, and he talks about it with enthusiasm and love, and it's good. He's an inspiration. I mean, I'm tied up to a rail the whole time, but even in that, it's a challenge for an actor to keep his energy up and to keep the same tension that Jerry has on the outside, you know. There's always a challenge in acting, and that was mine in this movie. You got to get your heartbeat up to 160 beats a minute for 3 weeks. You know, it's a scary situation. You know, not only do you have your son who's in the White House apart from you, but you know, you have nuclear destruction. You know, imminently awaiting the world, and so you know you have to. The audience has to believe that you believe that that's going to happen, and so you do whatever you can, and you improvise, you do push-ups, you run around, you swear at people, you know, have people hit you in the face. You know, it takes different measures on different days, so whatever it takes, that's what happens.
Talking about enthusiasm, I think fans can't wait for one of your next projects, Divergent, obviously a huge fan base for that. Can you talk a little bit about your character?
I can't say anything about that because you know how the Hollywood is, you know what I'm saying? It's very secretive these days, so I'm going to keep that one to me. But I do have a movie coming out called I, Frankenstein, where I play the monster of Frankenstein, which I think is quite exciting, so I think that comes out in the fall. It's the monster Frankenstein in the modern age, and he's looking for his soul and for love and his place in life, and he uses Cali stick fighting to do it, which is, wow. Yeah, it's a movie about good and evil and gargoyles and demons and something like you've never seen before, so it's going to be interesting.
Message for fans before you leave us, anything you'd like to say to all of them out there?
Dream big.
I love the idea of this movie. I started reading the script and I thought, okay, I dig this guy, Secret Service, ex-Special Forces. And then suddenly there's a C-130 plane coming in over the White House and this attack happens and you go, okay, this is so ballsy. This is like in your face. And I thought if we can do that, it was a little bit sci-fi at that time. I said, if we can do that and ground it and make this really a believable attack, get a great cast and show the humanity of the characters in that situation, then you have a movie. You have one. It's a movie that's it's exciting. It's edge of your seat, and at the same time, it's emotional and it's provocative. And that's what you know. That's what made me want to produce it.
And you said as well, you wanted the story to stay justified and real at all times. So how did you achieve that?
Well, we spoke with, spent a lot of time with members of the Secret Service, and said, how could an attack look? You know, they have plenty of stuff up their sleeves, but you know that still exists. But we call bullshit on each other. You know, I'd say, no, Antoine, the director, you know, no, you got to show me how you could get away with that, and he'd say the same to me. So we were always just making sure that everything had to be done in a way that would be outsmarting the opposition. And even what goes on in the White House, for instance, as a Secret Service guy, when you get in there, how do you assess enemy capabilities and establish lines of communication with the outside world? How do you start eliminating the enemy and psychological warfare? All stuff that once you get in there, it's really fascinating. What happens in the crisis room? What's going on there? How does everybody relate to each other? You know, what's the protocol? And then what happens in this movie when you run out of protocol? Because it gets so insane that, you know, nobody's ever been there before.
I think obviously you're working with a very special director in Antoine. What makes him so unique? And are you going to be working with him again? I think we hear he's going to be putting you in a submarine next.
I know. Well, the funny thing is we had about three different movies that we were kind of working on as ideas together. One of them is a submarine movie. And then this script came to me and I went right to him. I'm like, dude, come on, we got to do this. And he went, yeah, let's go. So it came together very quickly. And Antoine is incredible. I mean, nobody does gritty realism and with characters as well as with action that just pulls you in. It's unflinching. It doesn't look away and just, you know, he does it extraordinarily. And yet both our favorite movies is Apocalypse Now. So it's all about that mythical hero's journey. And he's also, you know, the guy's a Golden Glove boxer. So he's as tough as they come, but he's such a gentle, considerate soul, you know, and just a very smart guy who understands character and who also understands badassness. And that's important in this movie.
Do you have a message for fans before you leave us?
Hey everybody, how are you? I'm Jerry Butler. I have the movie Olympus Has Fallen. It's fantastic. And you should go and check it out, not just for me, but for yourselves.
Excited about the film?
I'm so excited. I only got my invite the other day, so I was like, oh. Gerard Butler, Aaron Eckhart, loving it.
We're even more excited to see the return of the 32s, the magnificent Game of Thrones. What can fans expect overall from this new series?
Overall? I think it's a bit of a game changer. People's fortunes kind of change very much. So like the people that don't really have any potential, they get dealt like a great hand of cards and then they're on top and vice versa. So it's going to be a shocker, I think. This is the shocking season.
In particular in store for your character this time? Are you getting good cards or bad cards?
Particular? I can't spoil. There's a lot of big changes for Sansa and she kind of goes from being like let me rephrase this. She goes from being used, she goes from being a chess piece to a player in the game. That was good.
Fans have their favorite players. Apart from your own character, who do you love? Do you have a favorite? Why do people hate you so much?
I don't know. I think she's a good character. My favorite is probably Jaime Lannister because he's like, you just don't know what he's gonna do and he's so complex. Like, I love him. I think he's brilliant. And Nikolai plays him so well.
The show just keeps getting bigger and bigger. The premiere of the first episode of Series 3, biggest audience yet in the States. Why do you think people all around the world love this show so much? Why?
Well, I think it's because, first of all, the writing. Like, it's just amazing. And then the storylines, there are tons of storylines, but there's something in it for everyone. You know, there's sex, there's intrigue, there's fighting. It's like every 12-year-old's, like, secret dream, like, you know, fighting swords and then like naked girls everywhere. But there is something for everyone, and I think also the fact that it's kind of put into a fantasy genre, it's not really that much fantasy. The fantastical elements are very much drip fed, so I think that's kind of what makes it very good, and the emotions are very true as well.
We're so pleased to see that HBO have officially now confirmed the fourth series. How do you feel about it?
So happy. It's good because I know what's in store for like a lot of the characters in season four. So it's going to be a really good season.
Have you read ahead then? Have you cheated? Have you read the book?
I read the book season by season. I just Wikipedia'd the rest. So I know what's happening, but I will read book four. I promise.
Fans will have their favourite moment so far in the series. Is there any in particular for you that you're really proud of or just look back on and have fond memories of from your time on set?
I think every scene has been so much fun to do, but most of my scenes have been with like Jack Gleeson, who plays Joffrey, and Lena Headey, who plays Cersei. They're probably the scenes that I have most fun with, definitely.
Do you have a message for Game of Thrones fans before you leave? Is anything you'd like to say to all those lovely people out there?
Thank you so much. We love you.
Are you working on anything else at the moment, or is it just all Game of Thrones?
I have a film coming out, and I think it's going to be December, so that should be quite fun. But nothing at the moment. We'll see.
Fans are going to want to know, what are you working on at the moment? Where are we going to see you, hear you next?
I just put a tweet, an Instagram up today, on one of my song notepads, saying that the next album's going to be absolutely amazing. Like, I'm very, very excited about this one. It's a bit more live, and I've got a lot more kind of orchestral and like kind of horn sections going on in this album, but I'm really excited about it. I think people are going to get to hear my voice more on this record, so I'm excited.
Any particular tracks you're especially proud of?
So far, I've got this big record called Mr. Nobody, and I think it's going to be fire.
Any live shows coming up?
There's always live shows. I don't even know my diary. It's always mad. My agent, he's like growing greys at the moment because he's got too much work to do.
Have you got a message for fans before you leave us to go inside and enjoy this wonderful film?
Have loads of fun, and I'll be seeing you soon. I love you guys. Peace.
I guess the first question fans are going to know, how's the new album coming along?
Oh, I'm so pleased it's all done. Took me a while. They actually did a sort of intervention with me, and they were like, are you done yet? Are you done? Have you chosen your songs? I wrote so much, and it was really difficult to sort of go, these are going to be the ones.
Fans who've waited a long time, what can they expect from the album overall?
A lot of truth. It's very real. I had so much that I wanted to say and a sound that I wanted to make, and so I took my time in doing that, but I think I did it.
Are there any particular tracks that you're especially excited for fans to get a chance to hear now?
Oh, I don't know. It's like choosing your favourite child.
Everyone does have a favourite child.
Everyone has a favourite child. My single, Save Me, is an important track. And my second single I wrote with Danny, that's called Alive. That's pretty important. There's a song on the album called Speed the Fire and another one called How We're Made. They're very sort of poignant and mean a lot. So it's going to be... going to be weird to have them out there in the atmosphere and they not just belong to me.
How important do you feel it is for music to have that kind of personal content to really expose part of yourself?
I think there's no point in music unless it's completely, utterly truthful and real and it's sort of saying exactly how you are and how you feel. You don't have to say it straight out. You can be as poetic as you like, but I think it's got to be your truth.
Is there anyone else you're listening to and you're particularly impressed by?
At the moment, Tom O'Dell, Ben Howard. I'm hooked on Sigur Rós. I don't stop listening to them, and I never stop listening to them. I just watched their live thing in Brixton a few weeks ago, and you know, I'm addicted to them. They're my favourite thing ever.
As you battle your Sigur Rós addiction, and now the album is finished, are we going to get to see you performing live? Are there shows coming up?
Yeah, I've got a sold out gig coming up on the 17th of April here in London, and then I'm going on tour in June. So I'm away all summer touring, really, yeah.
For anyone who missed out on those London tickets, where can we find out more about the tour in June?
On my website, but there are definitely still tickets for the tour, so please come. But look me up. I guess it'll be on Twitter. I'm just getting good at Twitter and working out how to sort of tell people what I'm doing. So, yeah.
Mastering your social media.
Yeah.
It's been a pleasure. My final question, do you have a message to fans, anything you'd like to say to all those lovely people who can't wait for the new album?
Just say thank you so much for waiting for me. You know, I took my time, but I hope you like it.
I'm so excited. I'm a big fan of action movies and obviously Gerard Butler, so really excited to see this.
Why are you such a fan of Gerard Butler in particular?
Oh, might be something to do with he's quite good looking and a very good actor, obviously.
Hard on the eyes. And what do you know about this film? Do you know anything in particular?
All I know is the White House gets blown up, basically.
How do you handle those kind of crisis situations? Do you think you'd be okay if terrorists were taking things over around you? Would you go old Bruce Willis Die Hard?
Definitely, I'd be the one straight in there, find everyone, get everyone out. Yeah, that'd be me.
What are you doing at the moment when you're not busy saving lives?
I'm actually recording my album at the moment and I've just released a new single and that's Music For Me, and we'll see how it goes from there.
Fans are going to want to know the new album, what's that going to sound like? What's inspiring you at the moment?
It's all very commercial pop, but I've also got a lot of like drum and bass dubstepy feeling there, so trying to like roll with the times, and we'll see how the good sound goes.
Clearly, dubstep seems to be bleeding over into pop music quite a lot. I mean, why do you think that particular fusion seems to be so popular at the moment?
I think it's more because of the fact that it's starting to get more commercial and people like something different on the ears. Instead of listening to like the really commercial, like dancey pop, they like to like bring it down and be a bit grimy. So.
Do you have any idea when we're going to get the album?
I think it's going to be at the beginning of next year. So I'm going to release another couple of singles first and then hopefully we'll be out with the album next year.
And final question, do you have a message to fans before you leave us?
Just keep an eye out on the new Made in Chelsea because it's going to be amazing. And buy my single, What Do You Want From Me, on iTunes now.
I am very, very excited. I love Gerard Butler, so I'm really excited about seeing him in his new movie.
We've heard a lot of that. Why do you love him?
Just look at him. He's beautiful. He's beautiful. I think I fell in love with him after I watched PS I Love You. So I think that's one of every girl's favourite movies. So yeah, he's very beautiful. So I think that's got a major part in why I love him so much.
Exciting to be here today. We've also had some very exciting news on the show, of course. Are you going to be watching? Are you going to be tuning in like everyone else?
Of course. I think I might be missing the episode tonight, but when I get home, I'll make sure that I watch it on catch up. I'm really excited about watching it and seeing the guys and what happens and the proposal. I think it's going to be really exciting.
Has it inspired any feelings in you? I mean, is marriage playing on the mind just yet?
Not yet. I think you can't put an age on these things, and when you feel ready, you feel ready. But I still feel that I'm a little bit young, and I don't know if I'm ready to kind of go forward with it yet. But in the future, I definitely see marriage on the cards. We'll see if Tom can stick around long enough.
Hopefully. Now, you're very busy at the moment with the fashion. Can you tell us a little bit about the new collection that's coming up at the moment?
So, I've got my spring summer, which is out at the moment, which is going really, really well. I had Asos, which were my new, I never know if it's Asos or ASOS, but they were my newest buyers of the range. So that was really exciting. It's done really well for them. So I'm just working now on my autumn winter, just getting it finalised at the moment. So that will be available around September, October time. So, yeah, really exciting and just working really hard at that.
What kind of things are inspiring you when you look to the fashion future for winter and autumn?
So I've got black coming back because obviously spring, summer, there was loads of colour and loads of print, but it's nice to get the little black dress back and bringing back some nice fabrics. It's always nice, I think, when you work with autumn and winter to use loads of lace and velvet. So it's nice to be bringing back some rich fabrics and some rich colours. Just kind of taking inspiration from the catwalk. There's loads of bows actually, but I won't let too much out. You can wait and see. It's going to be really exciting though.
I mean, fans are going to want to know, with fashion being such a big part of your life at the moment, do you see TV in your future? Is that something you want to go back to at some point?
Definitely. I think that if it was the right thing for me, I'd definitely love to go back to TV. There's a few things that I'm talking about at the moment in the pipeline. I think I just really want to do something with TV that relates to me. So, yeah, it definitely would be in the pipeline again.
Guys, it's great to have you here tonight. You excited about this film?
Yes. Very, very excited. We've been looking forward to it all week, so yeah. I'm ready to go watch it.
Why have you been so excited about this one?
A big Gerard Butler fan, yeah. Like a lot of his films, Machine Gun Preacher, PS I Love You, 300. What was your favourite one?
Law Abiding Citizen.
Yeah,
love that
citizen.
One.
So,
amazing.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it.
And of course in this film, he's defending the White House from evil terrorists. In that kind of situation, how do you think you guys would handle yourselves?
I'd just find a corner and hide behind a chair.
I reckon I'll dance my way out of it somehow. I'll do a little dance and I'll get out.
Body popping your way out of trouble. Speaking of dancing, what are you guys up to at the moment? What's next for you?
We just got back from China. We're over there for a few trips. We're judging the new street dance competition over there on CCTV. So it's looking to be huge. We're just having fun, looking forward to that. We're flying back out on Sunday. So
yeah. What's the talent been like out there? How impressed have you been?
We have been impressed. We haven't actually started filming yet. We did our first press conference and it was amazing. We saw one of the acts that's going to be performing and they were pretty insane. So we're really excited to see lots more.
Of course, street dance has gone completely global. Why do you think that has happened, particularly in the last few years? Why has it exploded all over the world?
I think it's just become something that's quite cool for everyone. You know, dance was quite a big thing anyway, but for boys and stuff to get into dance, street dance has made that quite the cool thing, and now it's spreading everywhere. There's a lot more groups on TV, there's a lot more people that people can look up to, kids can look up to, so everyone's kind of getting, it's a good way to express yourself,
it's
good way
cool
to have
well.
Fun.
It's yeah. Cool. So. I feel quite cool when I do it, so I'm guessing that's why everyone else does it.
Are you excited about this film?
Yeah, I can't wait to see it, actually. Big fan of Gerard Butler. I'm Edinburgh, he's Glasgow, there's a bit of competition, but he seems to be doing better at the moment, so I'm very keen to see his work.
Pretty great yourself, though. I mean, Fresh Meat, obviously a huge hit. Why do you think people have responded so well to the show?
I would say writing. The writers of the show are fantastic, and I think the chemistry between us as actors and friends has come across. So I think people just buy into the show because the writing's so good and the characters are so well drawn, and hopefully we perform that writing very well.
Of course, your character, Howard, is a bit of a fan favourite. Why do you think people love him so much in particular?
I think Howard's a bit of the kind of underdog, and people always kind of root for the underdog, and they want to see Howard do well. He's not a snappy dresser, he's not confident, although he can be confident in his own world, but I think people just want to see him do well, and I think with that, people are keen to tune in to see how his progression goes, how his character develops, I think.
What can we expect from Howard coming up? How would you like to see him develop as it goes on?
Well, I think judging from last season, he's obviously a big hit with the ladies now. He's very confident. I'd just like to see him keep doing what he's doing. I don't really know any of the storylines for this year at all, so I'll just be keen to see who he meets and which other characters are part of the dynamic and where he fits in. So I don't know yet, but hopefully just more of the good quality writing again.
Fans are going to be desperate to know, when are we going to get more Fresh Meat?
At the moment we're filming May till end of August, and then should be out September, October this year.
I'm sure it's a question you get asked all the time, but I mean, how does the experience of the show relate to your own experiences of higher education?
I think I was probably equally successful as Howard with women, and I've met a few JPs in my time, but I think what really gels actually in a strange way is that we all get on very well in our fake house, but as actors together we become really good friends, and I think that was one thing from my time at uni. I lived with a great group of people, and that's quite similar, I suppose.
From your own character, do you have a favourite? Is there one that you particularly identify with or enjoy watching?
I really enjoy watching everyone. I think Vod shouting soup fuck has to be one of my favourite lines in the series, so maybe I'll go with Vod for this one. And Zowie's great, but everyone's very good.
Are you working on anything else at the moment?
Yes, I'm writing something at the moment, which I can't really comment on. And then I've got a thing called Dates that comes out for Channel 4 in June, which I play opposite Gemma Chan, actually, who was in Fresh Meat Series 1. So look out for that.
Final question, do you have a message to fans? Anything you'd like to say to all those Fresh Meat devotees out there?
Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoy the next series, and I hope I'm in it, because that's not been confirmed, but I think I am.